Hello, today I'm not going to put the camera on for second reasons. I'm kind of sick today, so I will be coughing a lot. Today I'm going to be playing Piggy. Ew, there's a wasp in here. Not a wasp, I mean a thing. Ow, ow. Oh. What the? Who did I friend? It's basically a Roblox guest. Piggy. Piggy. They forgot to. See for why, not to eat. Which one? Piggy per 100 payers or Piggy but 0? So Piggy per 100 payers. I haven't played this game like in a while, like a billion years. Piggy but it's 100 players. 100 payers. 100 players. It's Piggy put 100 payers. Piggy put 100 payers. Piggy put 100 payers. They pay you off the horse. Pay you off the horse. Pay you off the horse. Okay, let's just wait. Why is it that the internet needed to change? Now it will definitely work. Yesterday I made a 1 hour video. I regret doing that. Ow, what was that? Ow, it burns. Bye, Minitoon. Join server. I think this game has admin commands. If it does, I'm going to buy them. What is that music? Let's see if the new update is in here. Up, down. Okay, I need to go to the normal world. Piggy. That's be like 15. No, that would be more than a year. Basically, it's been like more. Then 5 months since Piggy's out. And 40 Robux for 50. 79 Robux for 50. I'm gonna buy the last one. I don't have that much. I only have like 1,000. No! Why should I do that? I'm really short. Okay, let's get into this game. Am I the only one left? I'm gonna accept that. Don't challenge me to play a game with you. Go back. I need to bring the baby.
Wanna join this?
Oh, spawn, I need spawn. Where do you get spawn? I hate this. Spawn, are you in here? Okay, the NPCs are this. Okay, so I hate this. So, I'm just going to do a reacting video. Just wasted my 8 minutes. And was this? Okay. What should I react to? React. No. I stayed the same age for 20 years.
I lived up north where the temperatures were below freezing and the sun was a rare sight. I used to love ice skating and I would always go down to the frozen lake. I've been ice skating on that lake.
So story time animated.
Ever since I could remember. Literally, from what my mom told me, even as a fetus, I was skating on the ice. When she was pregnant, she was skating. When I was a day old, she skated with me in her arms. When I was 3 months old, I was already playing on the ice. Right until the age of 17, I was skating. That is, until the incident. The incident that cost me 20 years of my life. But we'll get into that later. When I was around 12 years old, I entered an ice skating competition in my local town. I won first place. Admittedly, there were only 5 other contestants, and some of them could barely stand on the ice. But still, I had won. From that point on, I skated competitively. My mom loved that I was ice skating. She used to ice skate a lot as a kid, but she had an accident that prevented her from competing competitively. She used to come watch me ice skate on the frozen lake, a smile always on her face. My dad wasn't as supportive. He wasn't really into ice skating. He thought of it as a mere hobby, not a sport. Instead, he had a huge devotion to football. Even though there were hardly any games around our location, he followed football teams avidly. He almost worshipped them. So did my brother, Will. He and my dad would sit in front of the TV, yelling as some ball was tossed and some guy was tackled. Personally, I didn't really see the fun in it. Maybe that's why me and my dad were never really that close. You see, Will was always his favorite. I think sometimes my dad even forgot he had a daughter. My brother reveled in it, too. He never wasted a second from telling me about the things he did with Dad. What fun they had on the trip together. But fine, whatever. Who cared if Dad didn't love me? I had my mom who loved me. That was how it was in our family. My mom loved me, my dad loved Will. And Will and I were always competing, always fighting. I remember one time we were at a festival. We were very young, barely in our teens yet. And my dad had come back with two ice creams. Except one had chocolate and the other had strawberry. My dad handed me the strawberry and Will the chocolate. Of course he did. Didn't my dad know strawberry was the one flavor I absolutely hated? But no, of course he didn't. I told my brother to give me his chocolate since he was fine with both flavors, but he wouldn't give it. So I started screaming and I tried to get it from him. Then we both started fighting each other. And alas, both ice creams fell to the ground. My dad got so mad at me. What about Will? But Will got away freely whilst I had to suffer a scolding from my dad. That was how it was with us. Except you would think that with my mom, I would get the special treatment. But my mom was all about fairness. So she would treat both of us fairly. I suppose I loved her even more for that. But still, Will got double the love. There was one time when I absolutely had it with Will. We were playing at a nearby park, playing on the swings, and Will was telling me all about the trip he had with Dad when they went fishing. I was so annoyed. Why did he have to rub it in? Would you just shut up? I snapped at him. Will was taken aback, but then he replied, "Stop being so jealous." "Stop showing off," I yelled. "You stop being so dumb. You're an idiot." "No, you are. You are. Dad doesn't love you," he finally shouted. I stopped. That was too far. Too far. I promptly stood up and ran off. I wouldn't waste my time with Will. I finally got home, but I didn't want to see neither my dad nor my mom right now. Instead, I slipped into the shed, grabbing my ice skating shoes, and stormed off to the frozen lake. It was especially cold today, and I only had a small coat on, but the anger inside me was enough to heat my body. I forced my shoes on, stepping onto the ice, and immediately I felt more relaxed. I always felt calmer here, at peace, like I could sort through my thoughts better. I slowly skated across the ice. At least that was one thing I had over my brother. I could skate so gracefully, whereas he could hardly walk across the ice. And he didn't even play football. Where could he, at a place where everything was frozen? I think he only pretended to like football to be closer to our dad. I did a small twirl and smiled as I stuck the landing. I felt better already. But then, as I skidded across the ice, I felt the ground shake beneath me. The ice was cracking. I tried to head back towards the shoreline, back towards solid ground, but I fell through the ice and plunged in the water. That's when I blacked out. I woke up seemingly just a few minutes later. I was in the hospital bed with all these wires plugged into me, and my family was there. They were all looking down at me with tears in their eyes. What happened? I asked. My mom burst into tears, and she grabbed hold of me in a crushing hug. My dad was there, and he smiled sadly. "You've been in a coma for 20 years," he said. My mouth fell open in shock. "What?" "It's true," said another man, a stranger stepping forward. I wondered who he was, but then I looked at his face, and I cried out. It was Will, except he seemed so much older. He was an adult. Now that I looked closer at my parents, I noticed their faces had many more wrinkles, and gray hairs sprouted across their head. Was it really true? Had I been in a coma for 20 years? I was shocked, to say the least. I couldn't even process the thought. 20 years of my life? Gone. I slowly raised myself from the bed, still dazed. There was a mirror in the corner of the room, so I stepped towards it, and I gasped. I still looked like a 17-year-old. I had expected to look much older like Will did, but I looked the same. What was going on? "Why haven't I aged?" I asked in awe. The doctor cleared his throat. "When you fell in the lake, you had been frozen solid by ice-cold water. Your growth system, your organs, they had all frozen, as if in a timeless state. In other words, you have stayed as a 17-year-old for 20 years. I stumbled back, and my mother caught me as I nearly fainted. I couldn't believe it. 20 years? I had lost 20 years that I could have spent with my family. I started crying, and then everyone started crying. We all held each other in a hug. Even my dad was holding on to me. My life had been ruined. My family took me home the next day. The doctor said I may be weak as I hadn't used my limbs for 20 years. I would need a lot of physio and mental therapy to get back to where I was 20 years ago. I immediately wanted to start skating again, but my mom told me I couldn't skate again for a while. That was the worst part. Skating was my way of escape. If I couldn't skate, then what was the point? The weirdest part was meeting my brother's children. He had kids already, but the thing was, they weren't that much younger than me. I felt more like an older sister than an aunt, and my brother felt more like an uncle. My parents felt more like grandparents. Everything had been thrown off track, and I really struggled those first few weeks after waking up from my coma. All of my friends from school were grown up as well. They were off getting jobs, caring for their own families, and me? I had just woken up from a 20-year coma. My entire life was not what it once was. I started going to school again, but I didn't know anybody. It was like I was the new kid again, which sucked. And then my parents passed away. They were already in their 70s, and I guess the stress of having a child in a 20-year coma had had its toll on their health. They passed away in the same week, leaving my brother and I alone. I lived with my brother and his family. They were all so nice to me, but I was mostly sad each day. I was lost. I didn't know what to do with my life. Will looked after me. I probably wouldn't have survived if it weren't for him. It seemed only yesterday to me that we had been fighting on that swing set. I wished I had never stormed off to the lake. Maybe if I hadn't, I would never have gotten into this coma. Everything would be back to normal. But I went, and I put myself into this situation. There was no one to blame but me. My brother had apologized to me a lot. He told me for all those years he had blamed himself. He had said such mean things to me, and that's why I had gone to the lake. But I told him I didn't blame him. My brother and I were really close from this horrific ordeal. I guess that was one positive from this horrific experience.
So who's the
and my physiotherapy was going well. Finally, 3 years after I first woke up from my coma, the doctors told me I could ice skate again. I was happier than I could have even dreamed. I went down to the frozen lake. I had insisted I could handle it, but Will told me he was going with me. He wouldn't risk another incident like what had happened last time. I didn't blame him. We went down to the frozen lake, and I was struck by sudden deja vu. I started to panic a little. I was so scared I would fall through the ice again and get into another 20-year coma. Would my brother still be alive? Would anyone I know still be alive? But my brother grabbed my hand and guided me on the ice. He told me he had practiced skating ever since I had gone into my coma. Now he was much better than me, but I wasn't jealous like I would have been 20 years ago. I was proud of him. We skated around the lake, my limbs still wobbly and weak. It seemed everything was fine. But then I slipped. My knees buckled and gave way before me, and I fell to the ground hard. My head hit the ice, and I blacked out again. I woke up in the hospital again, and I was so scared I had gone through another 20-year coma. No one was in the room. No one had noticed I was awake. I panicked. How long was I out? Was it more than 20 years? I called out, yelling for someone to come. Then my brother burst into the room. I looked at him carefully, desperate to see if he had any more gray hairs, if his face had any more wrinkles. But he looked exactly the same as I last remembered him. Oh. It's okay, he said, seeing my panic. You just hit your head. How long was I out? I asked. Will chuckled. A few hours. Don't worry, you're fine. I was so relieved. I started laughing too. And then we were both laughing.
Wrong button.
Get closer to the action.
Rocket
surprise,
no skating there.
In real time. Experience real
time. I'm making another video. Bye!